we do a three-way active system, you usually want to do the tweeters and the A-pillars, the 3-inch mid-range drivers inside of the dash, especially on these newer Silverados. It makes it a lot easier and there's no modification. As you can see, we pre-drilled and we're going to enlarge the hole. The tweeter will sit flush inside of there. Here are the factory Bose drivers. We're going to be upgrading them to these beautiful Hertz 3-inch drivers. All right, guys, let's go into some real detail. This is how we set up a three-way active system. I know we talk about it, but let's get into the real fine nick and trim of it. It's a beautiful product, Helix V8 DSP. This is an 8-channel amplifier and also has a built-in DSP, meaning you plug this into your computer and then you would tune it directly from your computer, set up all the crossovers, equalizers, and everything. But let's get down to how we wire a three-way active. In a conventional system, we usually use a 4-channel amplifier and a monoblock. On the 4-channel, if we were to use a three-way, one channel goes into a passive crossover. This crossover takes one input and then three out. So now you lose a lot of power because you're sharing the tweeter, mid-range, and mid-bass woofer. The big issue here is you've lost quality and power. So when we take that sucker out and we're crossover, and we're on a channel individually to each tweeter, mid, and mid-bass, you've got gobbles of power, power! And then we can have an absolutely high-end system tuned directly with a digital crossover on the DSP, and we would be able to obtain maximum power. Guys, three quick tips and secrets. Here's number one. On the passenger side, there's a fuse panel right here. You'll remove this trim cover. And if you take a look right over here where my finger is, next to this larger 50 amp red fuse, there's a male pin exposed. You can connect a female connector to that, and that is your main ignition line. So that will be the remote turn on and turn off for your amplifiers. This would save you guys a lot of time. Now we'll come here to the back and take a look at this. Here is the factory amplifier. This is where we're gonna grab all the connections. Tip number three, take a look right here under the seat. We've already got our monoblock mounted and look how clean that looks. You're not gonna have any overheating issues. The wire length to the battery are a lot shorter. The wire lengths to the back are very simple now. And everything looks clean. It's not gonna get stolen. You don't have to remove the complete rear compartment. As you can see, it's very difficult to work with that and run all the new lines all the way to the front battery. Less signal issues, less power issues, and you know what? Easy to get to as well. So that's our three tips for this one, besides obviously doing a quality install using proper materials and going to the pros.